Hi, this is Priyanka, working as an assistant professor in BVC Engineering College, Odalrevu. Today I would like to discuss the topic of evapotranspiration. So the evapotranspiration is it is one of the components of field water balancer. So basically we are talking about in this lecture I would like to share some important topics. First of all, what is evapotranspiration and how to measure the evapotranspiration, measures of evapotranspiration, and how to estimate the evapotranspiration, and some worked out examples. Okay, so first of all, you have to learn about what is evapotranspiration. So for example, if you see, whenever there is a water body, so there is a tendency to evaporate, right? So I think about you know, water on plant surface or water on soil or whenever in the lake or reservoir, definitely there is a water going to evaporate. So we are talking about, you know, so it has two parts. So first one is evaporation and second one is transpiration. So the combination of these two is known as evapotranspiration. So I will tell one example. So if you see this picture, so here the mostly the transpiration is going to takes place through the plant body. So this is the, so these are the plants. So the transpiration will be coming from plant leaves. So evaporation, if there is some water which is lying on the top of the leaves, so then that is going to evaporate, or maybe it is evaporate through the soil surface also. So the here we have to observe that the water levels are, water will be coming out from plant leaves and also the soil surfaces. So the combination of these two, plant leaves and the soil surface, is known as evapotranspiration. So evapotranspiration from soil surface, it is the crop field and the transpiration through a crop plant in a combined manner, that is called the evapotranspiration. So the knowledge of evapotranspiration is, it is an important for a practical point of view. So as far as irrigation or water requirements, it is very useful. So here exclusively if you see the evaporation, which is the change of water from the liquid to vapor form. So first of all, you have to learn about the definition of evaporation. So it is the change of water from liquid to vapor form. So here exclusively if you see the evaporation, which is the change of water from liquid to the vapor form. So the evaporation generally occurs all moist or wet surfaces. okay, including soil or water, plant and other water bodies and other soil surfaces. Okay. And coming to the next one is transpiration. Transpiration means it is evaporation from plant leaves through small openings in the leaves. So that is called stomata. So both the evaporation and transpiration occurs. This is basically due to the evapotranspiration. Okay. So the next topic is about factors influencing the evapotranspiration. So here evapotranspiration generally categorized into four factors. So first one is crop factor, and second one is weather factor, and third one is soil factor, and fourth one is management factor. So first of all, I will explain the crop factor. So the crop factor generally includes groundwater, root density and the plant height. Okay. So the groundwater, groundwater having a lot of cover at the top of the ground. So there will be a lot of, you know, evapotranspiration because the transpiration will be more and the root density will also more. So the groundwater and root density increases, the evapotranspiration will also increases. So next one is plant height. So plant height also influences the evapotranspiration. So parallelly plant height it also influences the evapotranspiration rate. So coming to the next one is weather factors. So this weather factor includes solar radiation, temperature, humidity, wind speed, and day length. So the solar radiation causes that, you know, evaporation rate faster and the temperature also increases the evaporation. So here solar radiation faster than the evapotranspiration rate. So coming to the next one is humidity. Humidity, whereas humidity, if you know moisture around, there will be evapotranspiration will also be less. Here temperature increases, the evapotranspiration will be decreases. So coming to the next one is wind speed. Wind speed increases, the evapotranspiration rate will also be more. Coming to the next one is day length. Day length also influences the temperature. So here solar radiation, so basically it is also one of the influencing factor of evapotranspiration. So all these four factors are influencing the evapotranspiration. So coming to the next one is soil factor. So the soil factor generally includes soil moisture, salinity and presence of impermeable layer. So these are the factors of soil factors. So all these three factors are including the soil factors. So the factors such as soil moisture. If you has a lot of soil moisture inside, the plant has a tendency to extract more water. So, and the salinity means it holds the soil particles, as well as salinity will be denser, so the evapotranspiration will also be less. So coming to the next one is presence of impermeable layer. It means influencing the evapotranspiration, it abstracts the water flow to the plant surfaces. And coming to the next one is management factor. So this management factor generally includes mulching, shading, weeding, irrigation and fertilizer applications. So these are the factors including the managing factors of evapotranspiration. So whereas weeding means weeding generally includes the evapotranspiration. So here weeding increases the evapotranspiration is also increases. And coming to the next one is amount of fertilizer applications. So amount of fertilizer applications, it deals with the group of crop health. So it deals with the crop health, and definitely it also influencing the green canopy. So the canopy increases, it also influences the evapotranspiration rate. So green canopy is also increases, the evapotranspiration is also increases. So the next topic is about how to determine the evapotranspiration. So the determination of evapotranspiration. So here there are two measurements. First one is direct measurements and second one is indirect measurements. So first of all, I will explain the direct measurement. So there are two direct methods, and there are some direct methods and some indirect methods in the determining evapotranspiration. So in this direct measurement involves the isolation of a portion of crop from its surroundings, and determining the evapotranspiration rate. Okay, by using the measurements. So this includes isolation portion of the crop from its surroundings and determining the evapotranspiration measurement. So basically, what happens? Evapotranspiration contains evaporation and transpiration. Okay, so in this particular case, we are measuring both components as we know simultaneously, then adding the MAP measuring, that with the direct measurement. Okay, coming to the next one is indirect measurement. So coming to the next one is indirect measurement. So basically it is calculated from three categories. So first one is calculated from crop and climatic data, and second one is theoretical and empirical equations. And coming to the third one is It is also used for the crops where measuring the evapotranspiration data, which is not actually this is not available. So coming to the so these three factors are the indirect measurements. Okay, so this is one of the kind of mostly the theoretical based indirect measures. So we are going to see both methods in brief, that is both method means direct and indirect measurements. So direct measures of evapotranspiration, it is also a field measurement. So here I mean if you recall the equation, that is a field water balance equation. First of all, I will explain the direct measurements of evapotranspiration. So in this direct measurement, one equation is there, that is a field measurement. So it is also known as field water balance method. Okay, so the formula for finding the evapotranspiration measurement in direct method is capital ET to the base of delta T equal to SM1 minus SM2 plus IR plus RE plus U minus D minus SR. Here SM1 is equal to sigma I equal to 1 to N into VMI into rho SI into ZI into 100. So these two equations are used for the calculation of evapotranspiration for field water balance method. So whereas ET to the base of delta T means evapotranspiration for time period. ET means evapotranspiration. So here delta T means it is the time between SM1 and SM2 readings. So the SM1 and SM2 readings are taken in mm. So whereas SM1 means it is the soil water content of the field plot. Field plot root zone at the beginning of the time period dt. Okay, coming to the next term is SM2. SM2 means soil water content of field plot at the, so this is the beginning and this is the ending of the root zone. Okay, so these two values are in taken as mm. So our next term is IR. IR means irrigation amount and next term is RE. RE means effective rainfall within this time period. So next one is U. U means upward flux, which is contribution from the groundwater to the root zone. And next one is D. D means water to the root zone, that means deep percolation, water deep percolation. And coming to the SR. SR means surface runoff. So these are the terms of field water balance equation. So if you have these measurements available, you can use this evapotranspiration by using the measurements of direct measurement. So generally How do you measure the soil measurement? If you recall the gravimetric equation. So I will explain the gravimetric equation. So the next equation is xm1 equal to sigma I equal to 1 to n Vmi into rho si into zi into 100. So these are the gravimetric equation. So here the terms, already explained the term, I will explain the term in the previous topic. And whereas Vmi means weight basis. So the units of Vmi is kg per kg. So rho si means density of soil, and zi means layer depth. So here 100 means it is multiplied with, 100 is multiplied with the all these three terms. So I mean it is a unit conversion. Okay, so the next topic is about evapotranspiration terminologies. So here there are three types. First one is potential evapotranspiration. So here the first one is potential evapotranspiration. It is also called PET. So this is the maximum rate at which the water, it is available, so it can be removed from the soil and the plant surfaces. So in this potential evaporation having no stress condition. So I mean the maximum rate at which the water is available, it can be removed from the soil and the plant surfaces. And coming to the next one is actual evapotranspiration. So it is also called as AET. So this actual evapotranspiration includes the atmospheric soil and vegetation condition. So here it will be, here the potential evaporation having no stress condition, but the actual evaporation having under stress condition, it is having some certain stress conditions. Okay, coming to the next one is reference crop evapotranspiration. So it is also called as ET0. So the reference crop evapotranspiration means it is the rate of evapotranspiration from an extensive surface of 8 to 15 centimeters tall green grass. So this tall green grass covered uniform height, actually growing and completely shading the ground, and it is not short of water. So basically it is having 8 to 15 centimeters of tall green grass. So here it is not short of water, that means it will be having not under water stress condition. So actual evaporation having under stress conditions, it is having not under stress conditions. Okay, so these are all three terminologies are related to evapotranspiration. And coming to the next topic is about indirect measurements of evapotranspiration. So first of all, computing the first of all computing the evapotranspiration involves the I will explain one equation. ETC equal to KC into ET power ET to the base of 0. So whereas ETC means evapotranspiration for a specific crop. So this ETC, the units of ETC is mm. Okay, next term is KC. KC means crop coefficient. So this is the one more equation in the direct measurement of evapotranspiration. And next one is adjusting for soil moisture. So the formula for finding the indirect measurement of evapotranspiration in this adjusting of soil moisture is ETC equal to KC into KS into ET0. So whereas ETC means evapotranspiration for a specific crop and KC means crop coefficient and KS equal to coefficient that depends upon the available soil moisture. So this KS term is depends upon the soil moisture content. Okay. So these are the two equations related to the indirect measurement of evapotranspiration. I will explain one example problem related to this evapotranspiration. So let us see. A class A pan was set up adjacent to a lake. The depth of water in the pan at beginning was 195 mm. In that week, a rainfall of 45 mm was absorbed and 15 mm of water was removed from the pan to keep the water level in the specified depth. If the depth of water at the end of the week was 190 mm. So calculate the pan evaporation using the suitable pan coefficient and estimate the lake evaporation of the particular week. So first of all, here the pan having the beginning of the data, depth of the water at the beginning is 195 mm. And here the observed rainfall value is 45 mm. And here at the end of the particular week, it will be removed. 15 mm of water will be removed from the span. So these are all about the particular pan. So first of all, based on these three data, you have to find out the total water present in that particular pan. So that is equal to beginning of the water, that is 195 mm plus observed water is 45 minus you have to be removed from the water into the pan. So you got 225 mm. So this is the total water present in the pan. So after that you have to find out the evaporation from the pan. Evaporation from the pan means, so total water present in the pan minus at end of the week. Here at the end of the week, the water depth is 190 mm. You have to be removed this particular depth. Okay, 225 minus 190 means 35 mm. Okay, so here you have to find out the pan coefficient. So here pan coefficient is not given in that particular problem. So you have to assume a pan coefficient equal to 0.7. So this 35 mm, this 35 mm will be taken as E pan. okay, so this 0.7 means it is the PAN coefficient KP. So you have to multiply it with EPAN into PAN coefficient. That means 35 into 0.7, that is 24.5 mm. So here, why we are multiplying with PAN coefficient? So you have a PAN, so you have to be multiplied with the PAN coefficient in this particular case. So because when we are taking about evaporation from any other field or any reservoir or lake or particular lake, so the evaporation from lake is not equal to the evaporation from the particular PAN. So that's why you are taking the PAN coefficient. Okay, so definitely the evaporation will be larger compared to the respective lake. So this is the reason for the correction factor of PAN coefficient. So that's why you are multiplying with the PAN coefficient to the respect to evaporation PAN. Okay. And coming to the next topic is estimation of crop coefficient. That means KC. Estimation of crop coefficient is denoted as KC, capital K suffix C. So here there are two coefficients. So first one is single crop coefficient and second one is dual crop coefficient. So I will explain first one. Single crop coefficient. Single crop coefficient, that means so here KC means KC includes the effect of evaporation from the plant on the soil surfaces. So KC means crop coefficient. So the formula for finding the KC crop coefficient in a single crop coefficient, KC equal to ET crop by ET zero. So this is the equation. So and coming to the next one is dual crop coefficient. So KC is splitted into two coefficients. One is crop transpiration and second one is basal crop coefficient. So that is KCB. And next one is soil evaporation, KE. Okay, so these are all about estimation of crop coefficient. I will explain another example problem related to evapotranspiration. Compute the evapotranspiration value in the month of July at a place 28 degrees north latitude if the long term data of temperature for the month of July is 30.5 degrees centigrade. The value of conservative use coefficient for the month may be taken as 0.6. Compute the value separately using Blaney-Kreidel method. So the formula for finding the Blaney-Kreidel method for you have to calculate the evapotranspiration in this particular method. So the formula is PET equal to small p into 0.46 T mean plus 8.188. So whereas PT means potential evapotranspiration. So the potential evapotranspiration units are mm per day per particular month or mm per month. So whereas T mean equal to mean daily temperature mean daily temperature per degree centigrade. So it is given as T mean equal to T maximum plus T minimum by 2. So generally small p, p means daily percentage of annual daytime, it is particularly in hours. So these are all about evapotranspiration by using the Blaney-Crandall method equation. So you have to find out the, we are using this formula. PET equal to small p into 0.46 into T mean plus 8.188. So here small p means, so here small p value here to be taken from the table. So based on the 28 degrees north latitude, you have to be taken the value from this particular case. So small p value is equal to 9.58. So PET equal to P into, that means 9.58 into 0.46 into T mean. T mean here, T value is also given, T mean. That is 30.5 degree centigrade plus 8.188. So by solving this, you got 8.58 into 22.218. That means 212.71 mm per days. So this is the potential evapotranspiration. So here compute the value separately. Here you have to assume the value of conceptive use coefficient. So conceptive use coefficient value is 0.6. okay, so after that you have to find out the actual evapotranspiration is equal to conceptive use into potential evapotranspiration, that is 0.6 into 212.71. You got 127.626. So this value is conceptive use value is less than actual potential evapotranspiration. Okay, you have to compare these two values. Okay, so this is all about the evapotranspiration problem. And coming to the next topic is about evaporation. So already you know the evapotranspiration. So evaporation and evapotranspiration, so these are the most important and most complicated phases in the hydrologic cycle. So these two phases redistribute the heat energy between the surfaces and atmosphere. Okay, so the estimates of evaporation and evapotranspiration, so these are required in the design of reservoirs, irrigation systems, scheduling and frequency of irrigation and water balance. So the evaporation, first of all you have to know the definition of evaporation. Evaporation means it is the process by which the water from liquid or solid state passes into the vapor state. So the water vapor, water from liquid into the vapor state, and it is diffused into atmosphere. So when water is converted from solid state to vapor state without passing through the liquid state, then it is called as sublimation. It is one of the important definition. Sublimation means when water is converted from solid state to vapor state without passing through the liquid state. So without adding the liquid state, you have to be converted into solid state to vapor state. It is also known as sublimation. And coming to the next one is transpiration. Transpiration means it is the process by which water passes from liquid to vapor state. Water passes from liquid to vapor state. So this vapor state through the plant metabolism is also known as transpiration. Most probably transpiration will be coming from plants or trees. So the process by which water is evaporated from wet surfaces and transferred by plants. So these are together evapotranspiration. So evapotranspiration is it is the combination of evaporation from plants and evaporation from soil or water surfaces. Okay, and coming to the next topic is about factors affecting the evaporation. So the factors affecting the evaporation. Evaporation will be categorized into two factors. First one is meteorological factors. And second one is physical factors. So in these meteorological factors, it will be categorized into five steps. First one is radiation, and second one is temperature, third one is humidity, fourth one is wind, and the last one is atmospheric pressure. So these are all about meteorological factors of evaporation. And next one is physical factors. So it will be categorized into three ways. First one is water quality, second one is size, and third one is shape of evaporating surface. So these are the factors of evaporation. So evaporation is expressed as the depth of water in mm's. It is escaped from a unit area in a given particular time. So it may be evaporation may be expressed as the mm per day or mm per month or mm per hour, etc. like this. So these are all about factors affecting the evaporation. So I hope you understand all those things in this particular topics. Thank you.